today the NCC is seen as providing a little land, you know, in terms of telecommunications regulation in Nigeria as number one on the continent, rather. What would you say, you know, has been responsible for NCC in achieving this kind of feat?
The Nigerian Communications Commission, as you have rightly said, is a leading light in regulatory performance in the continent, and not only in the continent actually, also internationally, because you may be aware that the commission was adjudged to be the best regulator in Africa by the International Telecoms Union, the ITU, for a period of 5 years in a row. And because of that, it puts the organization on the international limelight, and we have had our peers coming from all other countries come and see what we're doing and ask us how to do it. And some of the strategies and projects that we have ongoing that we think are good, some of them have replicated them in their own countries. I think for us as a regulator, one of the things, there are several things that are responsible. Well, I'll just speak to a few. One, you need to understand the business you're doing. You need to understand the sector, telecommunications sector. And you need to know what kind of regulation to use at any point in time.
That's fine. But I think the next revolution where everyone is hoping to see is the broadband revolution that will drive innovation. Are there specific things that the NCC is putting in place to ensure that we see a broadband revolution just as we saw the voice revolution?
Broadband has become like the oxygen for anyone in the sector. Yeah. You know that broadband is a requirement. It's no longer, some people now call it a human right. Some countries have gone ahead to say broadband should be a fundamental right. And I want to see a situation where Nigeria will get to that level where we say every Nigerian must have broadband. Because these days, without broadband, you can not do a lot. The commission has put in a lot of thoughts into what we need to do. And the plan, which I'm sure has been explained severally, is for us to have a very robust infrastructure, transmission infrastructure. Because without that infrastructure, we will not be able to achieve what we want to achieve.
Can you also let us into how the small and medium enterprises, the SMEs, you know, also contributed to telecoms growth in Nigeria today?
The small and medium scale industries, every economy needs them. And in Nigeria, we are not an exception. They are the ones who are usually the first to launch out.
Yes.
You know, you see something that needs to be done. You as an individual usually, and you think, how do I make it better?
Yes.
And then you begin to think about it, and you begin to put in place certain things that will help the economy.
Yes.
In the telecoms industry, we notice that, for instance, in the area of e-commerce, for a long time, Nigeria was not participating in that segment of the business. But in the last few years, 5 or 6 years now, we're beginning to see some major companies coming up, companies like Konga.com, Jumia.com, selling things on the internet. And sometimes they also provide a platform for those who cannot reach the international market. For instance, you have somebody in the village who knows how to knit, who is knitting baskets. Then such a person can use the Jumia platform to advertise what they can do, to place those things on that platform, and it becomes available internationally. And somebody can say, yes, they can do this in Nigeria.
In all of this, the oxygen of all of this is innovation and innovators.
Yes.
Okay, does NCC have anything to do with try to encourage innovations and innovators?
Yes. We want to encourage innovators because we know that they are the engine of growth. We have been really amazed at the power of the intellect of the young Nigerian. We've seen people who are building some technology for power that does not use petrol or diesel, that does not even also use battery. Because you know, we already know about the inverters. No, this doesn't use any of those, and it can last 24 hours.
Can you let us into some of the major achievements of the NCC and the industry, and how do you foresee the growth pattern, you know, in the future, and how the impact is?
The industry in Nigeria, it can be said to have been quite successful, because in the last 10 to 15 years, the subscription has grown exponentially. We're talking over 140 million subscription. Mobile services has expanded beyond our immediate, beyond the urban area. People in the rural area are also able to use mobile services. The industry is contributing to the GDP, gross domestic product of Nigeria. As at last count, it was over 9% of contribution to the GDP.
How do you foresee the growth pattern in the future? And
yes.
In impact that is likely to have in the industry?
What we foresee is that we are gradually moving away from just voice and moving into data. More and more operators are now establishing networks that are not only dedicated to voice, but is also able to do data. And now big data has become a major issue in international telecommunication discussions. Because when you go for any forum these days, they're talking about big data. They're talking about the Internet of Things, you know, how everything will be connected, and you can and the data that you're going to get from that, how are you going to mine in, how are you going to generate profit from the data. And so those are the areas that Nigeria too is going to be moving towards.